worst dressed. We've got a few candidates, but I'm going to go for Gerhard Tremel. He gets a lot of stick, and wouldn't surprise me if he's been nominated by a few. He's the clear winner in my eyes. Best dressed. There's a few who like to think they dress well, but I'd go with Nathan Dyer. You know, he likes his clothes, he spends a bit and he's always getting it tailored, and he likes to show us what he's got, so I think he's the best dressed, to be fair.
That's wrong, no?
That's right, that's fine. Perfect.
That's it. Well done.
Least intelligent. Well, we can't really put Tatey in at the moment because he's on load at crew, so we'll leave Tatey out of it, but I think at the moment, I think Neil Taylor comes out of some strange things.
Well, lads, don't know the way to the pitch, do you?
I wouldn't say he's the brightest. I think he likes to think he's quite intelligent, but realistically he's not. Ooh, most intelligent. There's not many in the squad who are that intelligent. Who am I going to go with? I think Geordie's quite clever.
Yeah, he's true.
You know, he's obviously he's a bit younger, and he's picked up the language very quickly, and he's I'd probably say he's the most intelligent, but like I say, he's not saying much in our squad. Worst taste in music. I think I'll go with Garry Tremel. He likes to play a few love songs on the way to games. You know, he sits on the back of the bus and his music's very loud on his headphones, and instead of putting a bit of dance music or something to get you up for the game, he likes to play a bit of love music, so I'd go with him. I'm just glad he doesn't choose the music in the changing room. Best trainer I'd go with, everyone trains well, to be fair here, but I'd go with Angel Rangel. I think he's trained very hard since the first day he's come in. You know, every day he puts the effort in, and you can see in matches he's always one of the ones who puts in the most distance in the games, and that comes from training very hard, and I'd say he's the best trainer out of the lot. Hardest tackler, I'd go John Joe. Obviously the fancy in games, he can throw a few tackles in, and he's no different in training, I think, especially when his team's losing or he's you know, he's missed a couple of chances or bad passes, you're just thinking, if I'm the next person nearest to him, I'm going to get clattered here. So he does like to go in with a challenge or two. The loudest player is the easiest, Ash.
Oh, what is goal scorer of the season?
Ash, you know, you can hear Ash before you see him down the corridors. He's just so loud around the training ground.
I thought he wanted to, like, do get on it. Like.
And he's laughing, and he's just shouting non-stop.
Yeah.
You know, he's like that on the pitch, obviously, as the captain. He's very loud, but I'm telling you now, he's just as loud in and around the training ground. You like to say, you can hear him before you see him. Most skillful player I'd give to Wayne Routledge. I think obviously it's always the forwards or the wingers who are the ones who are probably the most technically gifted, and Wayne, some of the things he does with the ball in training and in matches, we all see is, you just struggle to believe how he does it. You know, he's such a skillful player, and you know, he's settled here now for the last three or four seasons, and he's gone from strength to strength. But the most skillful, you know, the skills he's got is without a doubt is the best as well. Biggest moaner, there's a long list of moaners here. I'm gonna put a few in. Angel Rangel loves moaning in training. Yeah, he moans all the time at any decision Kurt gives or anyone gives, he's always moaning. John Joe. I think Angel and John Joe. John Joe loves a moan as well. If someone gives him a bad ball or someone doesn't get onto one of his passes, he moans. But Angel moans at the coaching staff when they give bad decisions. So them two are the easy candidates. Best banter, to be honest, we've had a bit of a dry spell in the banter stakes in the squad at the moment. There's a few boring ones, but I think one who's had the best banter is still around the club is Truns. I think when he was player, when as a player, he was always joking about great in the changing room, and as his club ambassador now, he's still about, and he's always joking about and taking the mick out of people, and he's still the same Trons that we knew as a player. So I'd go with Trons.
Probably Brad Pitt, me, and David Guest had played Leon.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it. Liam, okay, so go if you just finish.
I'm only messing.
Hey, cut that bit out the end of the way.